Elon Musk announced that the year 2029 will be the new deadline for humans to finally set foot on Mars, exactly 60 years after the very first moon landing in 1969. The ticket to go on this pioneering journey to Mars is just $100,000. Can you even imagine? You waking up in the morning on a totally different planet. This will no longer be science fiction, but a real possibility for humans thanks to the obsessive work of the world's richest man. Elon Musk was very serious when he said that he wanted to make humans a multiplanetary species with the reusable rockets by SpaceX, and that's exactly the reason why SpaceX has already begun testing prototype designs for their 400-foot-tall Starship rocket, as well as a launch pad in Florida that is capable of accommodating this massive vehicle. If all of this sounds exciting to you, stick around till the end of the video to know how Elon Musk plans to colonize Mars. As opposed to our blue planet, there is no oxygen or functional biosphere on Mars. Basically, there is nothing that can support life on the red planet as we know it. But that doesn't stop Elon Musk from colonizing Mars with a gigantic starship. Elon Musk stated that for the entire Mars colonization plan to become feasible, SpaceX will need about 1,000 ships, each carrying about 100 passengers, in order to develop a self-sustaining colony on Mars. He also quoted a hypothetical price of about $100,000 per person for a trip to Mars. When asked about why Mars colonization is important, Musk said, "I think this is important for maximizing the probable lifespan of humanity or consciousness. Human civilization could come to an end for external reasons, like a giant meteor or supervolcanoes or extreme climate change or World War III, or you know, any one of a number of reasons." In 2016, Musk said, "History is going to bifurcate along two directions. One path is we stay on Earth forever, and then there will be some eventual extinction event." So how exactly will SpaceX colonize the red planet? The answer to that lies with the Starship. SpaceX's Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy rocket, collectively known as Starship, is a fully reusable transportation system that is designed to carry both crew and cargo to the Earth's orbit, Moon, Mars, and beyond. As of now, Starship is the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever developed, with the ability to carry an excess of 100 metric tons to the Earth orbit alone. It stands at about 394 feet or 120 meters tall, with a diameter of 9 meters or 30 feet. Once the Starship is ready for interplanetary space travel, it will be entering the Mars atmosphere at about 7.5 kilometers per second and will decelerate aerodynamically. The vehicle's heat shield is designed to withstand multiple entries. But the spacecraft entering the Mars atmosphere is really hot, which could result in the wear and tear of the heat shield, which shouldn't be a surprise. The Starship is powered by the Raptor engine, a reusable methalox staged combustion engine that powers the Starship system. Raptor engines began its testing phase on the Starship prototype rockets back in July 2019, becoming the first full-flow staged combustion rocket engine ever flown. The Starship was initially known as Big Falcon Rocket, or the Interplanetary Transport System, but then SpaceX decided to change the name to Starship. Starship is also the name for the second stage of the two-stage vehicle. The Starship stage is the most important part of the entire system, with all the cargo and crew inside. It is stacked on a first stage known as Super Heavy. SpaceX states that the Super Heavy is necessary to get the spacecraft out of the influence of Earth's gravity with enough fuel to get this going. Starship can also travel to its destination, like, for example, Mars, and then launch itself back to space without the Super Heavy, all thanks to the low gravity on Mars. But what's more exciting about the Starship is the fact that it's fully reusable, which means it can bring down the cost of the entire journey. The Starship is more important than you think because it can be used for suborbital flights and could replace airplanes altogether if SpaceX is able to figure out the economics of scale. The new engines in the Starship burn hotter than its predecessors, and its interior can hold much greater amounts of pressure in the rocket engine. Chamber pressure is dictated by the amount of fuel and oxidizing agent that can be mixed and ignited, which will then generate thrust to lift the rocket. While increasing the chamber pressure creates a much more powerful rocket, it also significantly increases the risk of melting the engine itself. Musk said, it's got on the order of a gigawatt of heat. A gigawatt is like what a nuclear power plant produces, so it really is desperately trying to melt at any point in time. The problems that SpaceX is facing with the new engine is creating a headache for Elon Musk. Right now, of any technical problem, I'm spending the most time personally on Raptor 2, Musk told reporters. He described the engine as one of his two most vexing challenges, alongside his role as Tesla's CEO, and trying to improve that company's not-so-great self-driving software. So in order to fix the engine melting issue, SpaceX is now working on applying several heat shields that can absorb immense energy. If you think it was the only problem that Elon Musk had to deal with the Raptor 2, well, that is not the case. Musk warned his staff of a genuine risk of bankruptcy if SpaceX won't be able to fix the production issues. He also urged SpaceX employees to join him in working through the long Thanksgiving weekend last year. Elon Musk stated that SpaceX engineers are very close to solving the engine problems, but we also know Elon Musk has the bad habit of missing his deadlines. There is another billionaire who is also part of the space race who thinks Musk should focus on Earth instead of Mars. Jeff Bezos hinted that Elon should go live on top of Mount Everest for a year if he really wants to colonize Mars. Jeff Bezos stated this during a private talk about his aerospace company, Blue Origin. Bezos wants Blue Origin to help move heavy industries into space and protect the planet. But let's face it, that's not practical because of all the logistics involved. We think Elon Musk clearly knows this, which is why Elon said that the first settlers to arrive on Mars should not be expecting a glamorous lifestyle or even safe conditions during their stay. Musk gave the warning while detailing the efforts of SpaceX in developing their reusable Starship that will be capable of shuttling dozens of humans to the Red Planet, along with all the equipment that they need to survive and build a thriving colony in the future. Mars is known for its extremely hostile surface and atmosphere. Significant research shows us that the landscape of Mars is pretty treacherous. Astronauts will face obstacles like dust on solar panels or something similar to the tiny Mars rocks, becoming a nuisance for NASA's Curiosity mission. It's very important to emphasize that Mars, especially in the beginning, will not be luxurious. It will be dangerous, cramped, difficult, hard work, Musk said during a recent interview with the head of TED Conferences, Chris Anderson. The sales pitch for going to Mars is, it's dangerous, it's cramped, you might not make it back. It's difficult, it's hard work. That's the sales pitch, but it'll be glorious, Musk added. With all these inconveniences, why exactly did Elon choose Mars? Well, Mars, at least on average, is 140 million miles away from our planet, making Mars one of the closest habitable neighboring planets that we know today. Mars also has decent sunlight, which is necessary to sustain life. The atmosphere is primarily carbon dioxide with some nitrogen along with few other trace elements. A Martian day is also remarkably close to what we have on Earth. When it comes to gravity, Mars has about 38% of the Earth's gravity, so you'll be able to lift heavy things and just move around really easily. So, what is Elon Musk's motivation to do this? Life can't just be about solving problems, Musk said. There have to be things that inspire you, that move your heart. When you wake up in the morning, you're excited about the future. Musk also added, if moving to Mars costs, for argument's sake, $100,000, then I think almost anyone can work and save up and eventually have $100,000 and be able to go to Mars if they want. So it looks like the space race is now between billionaires, but Elon Musk wants to take it a step further by colonizing the Red Planet. Musk wants to establish a city on Mars, at least that's what he said back in December 2020. He also wanted to achieve this milestone anywhere between 2024 to 2026. It looks like Elon Musk had to rethink his deadline, as he now thinks the year 2029 will be the year for humans to place their foot on Mars. 2029 is 60 years after the very first moon landing of 1969. Well, you cannot blame Musk and SpaceX for the unfulfilled deadlines because both Elon Musk and SpaceX had to overcome several obstacles, especially the lawsuit filed by Blue Origin, Jeff Bezos' U.S.-based aerospace transportation company, against NASA. The decision of NASA to award a multi-million dollar contract to SpaceX to develop Starship was not well received by Blue Origin and Dynetics, as both companies thought it was unfair. So, Musk is now all set to get to his goal of colonizing Mars. We still don't know how long we should wait, but it should happen during our lifetime, at least according to Musk himself. maybe Musk was right when he said, "The joke I make all the time is that excitement is guaranteed. Success is not guaranteed, but excitement certainly is."